I've had a really lovely day. Yeah. It's just very nice. You meet very nice people who sort of seem happy to see you. And what's wrong with that? That's all right, isn't it? No.
And when you do meet fans, what are the most common questions people have been firing at you?
What was it like working on Game of Thrones or Doctor Who? And it's very easy to tell them. You know, been fantastic, two exciting big series. Doctor Who was the one I was on with Chris Eccleston, was one of the new ones, the Bring Back series, so there's a huge buzz about that. And of course, Game of Thrones is just the mega series that it is. Fantastic. The thing, Chris was a superb actor, and I've worked with him on one or two other things, and he's just a very nice guy, he's a very warm and human guy, and a brilliant actor. And he just finds the truth of whatever character he's playing. And you just go with that. You just want to watch him.
Of course, Doctor Who remains the most beloved and long-running television show. Why do you think that is? What's the magic of Doctor Who?
Well, I was watching Doctor Who back in the 1960s, hiding behind the sofa like everyone else did. What is the magic? It's frightening. If you're a child, it's frightening, but not so frightening that you're absolutely, you know, terrified. It's exciting. It's glamorous. It's different. Takes you out of the world that you know and understand. It's what's not to love. It's fantastic.
What are your fondest memories of your time on set with Doctor Who?
I think just sitting outside the set. We were filming at a castle outside Cardiff. And sitting outside, we had this sort of semicircle of chairs, chatting with other members of the cast, waiting to go on and do your bit. Lovely. Just sitting in the porch of this castle. Very nice indeed. Happy days.
Game of Thrones. Why do you think it has become such a global phenomenon?
Well, Russell, I've never seen a single episode. So I have no idea. I don't get Sky TV. I've never read the books. My daughters, however, this is the only production they're impressed that I've been in. The fact that I'm in Game of Thrones is the one thing they think is worthwhile. So what is it? You know, I mean, I've seen bits of episodes and I can see it's beautifully done. The production values are fantastic. It looks stunning. The stories are obviously exciting and exhilarating. And the characters are fascinating. All of those, that huge parade of people and different characters, it can't miss.
Of course, I mean, the show is hugely successful, but it's also a little controversial. I think the sex and violence provokes a strong reaction. How do you feel about that element of the show as someone who's part of it?
Well, the trouble is, Russell, is I've never seen any of that. So that's the problem. But I've heard a lot about the Sansa rape scene, which I haven't seen, and I don't know how it was done. I think, what can I say? If it's part of the story, that's what happens in life. And I know that Game of Thrones isn't real life as we all understand it, but it's human. It's about what happens with human beings. Terrible things happen, and they probably need to be portrayed.
Is the epic BBC adaptation of Pride and Prejudice. Can you talk a little bit about being part of that definitive version of that classic story?
Yeah, that was wonderful, because that what was nice about that is so often in television, you do bits, you come in, you go, you're, but on Pride and Prejudice, we were pretty much there all the way through. So there was a wonderful esprit amongst the cast. We all got to know each other very well, and it was great fun to do. And I think that enjoyment that we all had just as working with each other came across on screen. And it just was superb series, wasn't it? I mean, wonderful cast, apart from anything else. Colin Firth, I mean, Jennifer Ely, superb. You know, how could you do better? Well, they just seemed to get on very well anyway. They obviously had a great affinity, and they instantly worked together very well. And that spread throughout the entire company. As I said, the entire company worked well together. It was more like doing a theatre job than doing a television job, because we were all together so much of the time, doing those great big ballroom scenes and things, that everyone just began to click, and Jennifer and Colin, absolutely, yeah.
What was it like slipping into the costume, and particularly those big ballroom scenes?
The costumes are quite demanding, yes. They take a long time. Colin Firth and I used to have a little competition who could eat the hottest curry and then do the earliest start the next day, because you probably don't want to know this, but once you're in those costumes with all the hook and eyes, you can't get out of them very quickly. They were fantastic to wear. They make you hold yourself. They give you the period, and they help you portray the characters. But they are, yeah, you're quite happy to get out of them at the end of the day, I must admit, yeah.
As a nation, we remain obsessed with period drama. Why do you think that is? What's our fascination with our history?
Well, isn't it? It's funny, I saw another cab driver coming in today from the station. And he was saying, you know, the modern world is so fast, isn't it? So immediate, all the internet, everything is instant gratification. And just harking back to slower periods of our life where there seemed to be more time. Time is so precious now, none of us seem to have it. But then there seemed to be time, and it's just so nice to sink back into a period which was probably a nightmare for most people. But for the people you're seeing on television in these great dramas, life is wonderful. And for a moment, we're part of it. And it's a lovely release from what a lot of people have to go through in the modern world. Well, I'm doing a little bit for E4, and then I think I'm back on Game of Thrones, which is lovely.
We look forward to seeing you back on Thrones. My final question, have you got a message, I guess, particularly to Thrones fans before you leave us?
Well, to all Thrones fans, thank you for watching. It's wonderful to be a part of your viewing pleasure, and I hope you continue to enjoy the series.